number one question they ask him. Fuck every question you ask him. God. Hello everybody, good day. It's great to meet you. Yes, as you've heard, I am responsible for so-called case implementation, and what actually case is what I would like to tell you about. So what am I doing at all with this company? Before, however, I would like to introduce you to somebody, because in fact, I did not come alone today. I came today together with Mercedes. Hey Mercedes, say hi to the audience.
Hi there.
Mercedes, could you help me start this presentation perhaps by telling a joke?
Sorry, my engineers were Germans.
I always forget this. Then, okay, help me another way. I've heard so many hard discussions during the lunch, which was great, but perhaps it would help us if you could cool down the atmosphere a bit.
Air conditioning is turned on.
Yeah, thank you. Now it's much nicer. In fact, it's much nicer than when I left Warsaw. You know, it was looking like it was going to rain in a moment.
It is very unlikely that it will rain in Warsaw today with a low of 2 and a high of 18 degrees.
Oh, really? Great. If you're such a great expert in weather forecasting, could you perhaps tell me what is the weather in Bratislava? You know, I'm going there for a motorbike ride within a couple of next days.
Currently, it is mostly sunny in Bratislava with a temperature of 14 degrees.
That's really great. You know, I really love these motorbike rides.
Well, they say love is all you need.
And you're a very smart computer, aren't you?
You can't really tell, but I'm blushing.
If you're such a smart computer, could you perhaps help me with this problem? Because I think I forgot to tell my boss I need to take a couple days off for this ride.
I'm calling the mobile phone of boss.
No, wait. I have to mentally prepare for that. Give me a minute. Also, in fact, I have to check if I still fit after the winter into my motorcycle trousers, so I have to check it.
Dialing the mobile number of fitness club.
How dare you, counsel! I'm sorry we are not going to continue this conversation. I really love Mercedes, I love its artificial intelligence, but sometimes you just can't talk to this machine. She doesn't have any respect for you. So, what is CASE? As you've already heard, within Megatrends, as a part of Megatrends, this is connected, autonomous, shared electric. And starting with electric. Probably you are all aware that this is like a very big issue for all the automakers. Nearly everybody is now starting to produce electric cars. And this is also the most challengeable ones now, because we need the infrastructure, etc. What is important for us, I mean, just to show you the scale, what we are planning, we would like to sell about 25% of electrified cars, meaning electric cars and plug-in hybrids, which 25% is a lot. So yes, electric is probably the most important for today and like the biggest challenge. However, it's not everything. C stands for connected, which is probably the biggest topic during the conference today. You've heard pretty a lot about the C, and I will also carry on talking about it. Just my discussion with the computer, which was, I unfortunately could not bring here the real car because it's impossible in this area, but still, these were the real natural answers of Mercedes. I mean, this was not kind of synthesizer giving me a fake answers for a funny sketch. These were real answers from Mercedes, and that can be only guaranteed when the car and the system is connected and intelligent. Then we have autonomous, which is also very attractive and interesting topic, but probably the still furthest away when we talk about time. And then the last one, shared services with an important information that actually connected plus autonomous gives shared services. Why? We have many shared services already right now, but you really cannot have the ultimate shared mobility as convenient as exclusive mobility before the car is connected and autonomous. But I will go into detail with that. I'll still start with the connected. So, well, all the cars, of course, are connected in some way today. Most of the new cars can be connected by a mobile phone with an app. You can check where the car is, you can open or close the door, perhaps open the window, check its fuel, its range, and do other basic stuff with that. We also have that in a system called Mercedes Me, but this is, of course, just the first step on our longer way to real connected cars. The next step example of the system, because my colleagues here were already talking about connected cars, but they were talking more about technology, about the technological challenges. But at the end, it's about getting this product into the market. You have to capitalize the idea, you have to sell it, somebody must buy it, it must be convenient, it cannot be only in science fiction area. So this is what we are doing. And MBUX, Mercedes-Benz User Experience, better known as Hey Mercedes, is a great example of a connected intelligent system that helps the owner steer the car, but connect with it in each and every way possible. What are the main news about this kind of systems? The biggest thing is that the system has its artificial intelligence, and that's why you don't have to command the system. Previously, most of cars already had systems that, understanding your speech, so you said, please navigate to Berlin, and then the car was navigating you to Berlin, or please call mom, and then mom was called. The difference here is that you can actually talk to the car. You don't need to say, please change the temperature to 21 degrees. You say, hey Mercedes, I'm cold. Okay, I'm heating up to 21 degrees. Hey Mercedes, do I need an umbrella? Well, it's 80% that it's going to rain in the place where you are. What is also important is that the system is learning. For example, if I say very often that I'm cold, and it has default setting that for my command it will heat up 2 degrees, but then I repeat the command, he understands that 2 degrees is probably not enough for me. That's why in the future when I again ask him that, when I tell him that I'm cold, he will heat up with 2 degrees, with 3 degrees or 4 degrees, not with 2. What is another important aspect of the MBUX is that, of course, it's connecting with the Internet of Things, with everything around us. The example of ultimate goal of this system, from the user's perspective, is that I'm coming back with my connected car to my home, and I say, hey Mercedes, I would like scrambled eggs with bacon for the supper. And then my intelligent Mercedes connects to my home Alexa, the Alexa connects with the refrigerator, my intelligent refrigerator checks what's inside, and then Mercedes tells me, well, you have some eggs, but you need to buy bacon, or should I order it for you? Of course, when we are talking about now and today, we still have some time to really go to this level, but connecting the systems like MBUX with Alexa or Siri or Hey Google, which you probably all know, and they exist, and probably they even have a little bit better speak sensors than Mercedes has, but they don't actually operate a car, and they are not actually responsible sometimes even for the life of the passenger. And here is where we get to the next one, to the next part, which is autonomous driving. So you've heard already, technically it's already not a challenge. I mean, we can ride autonomous cars. In fact, when we are talking about even only my company, we had some first big autonomous drive tests already in the 90s. There was a project called Eureka Prometheus, and with an S-Class in 1995, the car made about 1,000 miles from Munich to Copenhagen with German Autobahns autonomously. Of course, you can see there up the picture, they had to have all the computers on board of the car. It didn't connect with anything. I mean, the GSM was just starting to spread in Europe, but still, they made it 1,600 kilometers. The next significant time was 2013 when we made the so-called S500 intelligent drive, and the car made totally autonomously the historical route from Mannheim to Pforzheim. It was a normal car, I mean, it didn't have any new extra computers. It was, of course, connected all the time with some servers that were helping to operate the car. But it was fully autonomous, you know, normal drive, normal people going around, bicycles, dogs, pedestrians, etc. What is interesting, you see here this black part of the car, this is actually the real autonomous car we want to offer. What you see up there, this transportation module can be changed, which means that the same car can be both a van, a bus, a passenger car. So it has the platform that is autonomous and is moving itself, but then it can change, let's say, the body. And we believe that this is now not a problem of technology. Technology will come, technology is almost now and here. The problem is making people believe in autonomous cars. I'm sure you have heard about the accidents, especially with Tesla. You've heard probably about the fatal accident in Arizona last year with a cyclist. Yes, of course, accidents happen and they will happen. And the machines also make errors. But please do not forget that the biggest major reason of accidents on the streets are people, are failures made by people. And machines can really lower down this risk. And in my personal opinion, there will come a day when it will be forbidden for human to drive on a public street because he will be a danger for other autonomous car users. Then we go to shared and services. Perhaps you've heard that most of the, well, maybe not most, but some of the automotive makers are not actually automotive makers anymore. They are becoming mobility services providers. And we believe we are one of them. I mean, we believe that the future is not in exclusively having a car. The people want now to move. They want to be mobile. They want to have this freedom of movement. And they don't really need to possess a car. All the statistics, researches show that there are less and less people, young people, making driving licenses, especially in big cities. And I don't mean only great metropolises as London, Tokyo, I don't know, New York. I'm talking also about, let's say, smaller cities in global terms, like Szczecin, Warsaw. People don't really often need a car. It's more convenient to take a bike, to take a taxi, to take a car sharing, because they don't have to worry about parking, they don't have to pay for the parking, they actually don't have to worry about the car after they finish driving. It's not their problem. That's what they expect. But the car sharing stuff, the taxis, this is not really, I mean, we are developing that fast. But we are trying to go one step forward, and I just wanted to show you one of the ideas we have, what will be the future mobility like.
Finally, the urban mobility gets into the third dimension. Life is about shared autonomous transportation systems. On the street and even in the air. Different means of transportation will seamlessly be integrated in existing and future mobility ecosystems. It's never been so easy. It's never been so exciting. Now is the chance for us to think about new mobility solutions in the next dimension. Man's dream of flying comes true.
What you have seen here is also not a science fiction. Volocopter is a real project. It's a startup bought by Daimler, which we are developing. And you've seen some tests already made in Dubai. And we are also launching new tests this year in Singapore. Probably before volocopters and this kind of devices arrive also to Poland, to smaller cities, it will take time, I'm sure about it. But we believe that we have to be very multimodal because this is the future of mobility. And just about the volocopter, it's not only autonomous, it's not only helicopter flying, it's electric. And of course, it's connected all the time because otherwise it would probably crash, which we don't want. That's why it's an ultimate, and it's shared. that's why I would say this is the ultimate example of what is case in praxis. And then we come back to electric. Now a very hot topic. I don't know if you have occasion to visit automotive shows. Everybody is now showing electric cars. Everybody is now showing hydrogen cars. Hydrogen cars, not everybody, but everybody is talking about it. Plug-in hybrids or non-plug-in, but still hybrid cars. This is a big issue. Why? We believe that the fuels, the oil, that will end. This is surely known. We need to convert into into cleaner resources. We need to turn into resources that will not end. That's why we would like to really start developing electric cars. And here is a question to you. How do you think, how new is this idea? When did Mercedes create its first electric car? Give it 60s, 80s? Actually, it was a long time ago, 1906. As you see, first electric Mercedes called Mercedes Electric. What is interesting, in fact, all in all, it was a very similar technology to what we have today. Of course, the battery was a little bit weaker. On the other hand, the car wasn't really going 100 kilometers per hour. It didn't have radio. It didn't need a Navi. It didn't need air conditioning because, in fact, it didn't even have windows or a roof. So it was much easier. But already then, the car had the same problems as today. It was relatively expensive. It was a problem to charge it. It took too much time to charge it. However, we believe that we are breaking these barriers. And just an example, the first electric Mercedes has been already, the first modern electric Mercedes has already been presented last year. And still this year, it will be also available here in Poland. It's called the EQC, mid-segment SUV, a four-wheel drive car. It will have a range of about 400 kilometers. You will be able to charge it with a fast charger within about 30, 40 minutes. So it's absolutely convenient. It should be absolutely enough for a daily route. What is important when we are talking about electric cars, because many people, yes, they say that, especially Poland or let's say less developed countries than Germany or United States or Great Britain do not have the charging infrastructure. Yes, but what you need to remember is that all researches show that about 70-80% of the electric car users charge at home, meaning that if you have a home charger, you are 80% independent from any public infrastructure. In fact, when you have a range of 400 kilometers and you can charge your car at your place of living or at your place of work, how often do you really make a ride longer than 400 kilometers? Of course, probably some of you do. Yeah, I get it. But 95% of us don't. On average, a person living in a big city with a family makes daily 30, 50, maybe 70 kilometers, not more. That means that 400 kilometers and having a home charger is actually enough. And I claim to say that, yes, we are ready for electric mobility. Of course, it still needs some legislation. It needs some changing in the minds of the users. But yes, even in Poland, we are ready. And we already tested that idea with electric smart. I'm not sure if everybody knows here that my company, Daimler, is also the manufacturer of this funny small urban cars called smarts, which have been the first electric serial produced cars in the world. And we started this production over 10 years ago, before actually Tesla hit the markets with the mass sold cars. So what is our roadmap here? We start with developing C and D. We develop all the four letters, of course. However, the most important today are the C and E. We are heavily, strongly cooperating here with providers of both of solutions, connected services and electric powertrains. And our biggest concern is to kill the pain points of electric car, meaning problems with charging, meaning making it a bit more perhaps cheaper, available, because there is a problem with availability of batteries. We want to make the electric cars as convenient as combustion engine cars. And that can be only made if we also integrate the letter C. Why? Because, for example, if you are now planning a longer route in a country like Poland, when there are not so many charging devices, you need to have an intelligent support that will tell you which route to take, where are the superchargers, how much time will I need to stop there. Maybe I should plan my ride so that I will need to stop for 1 hour at point X, but then I will have time for some refreshment, to eating a dinner, or I don't know, to making a telco. So we need intelligent connected systems to really help us introduce the letter E. But we also need it for letter S. And why is that? We believe that there are these, you see, two main trends, exclusive mobility and shared mobility. Exclusive mobility, meaning possessing, having a private car, is absolutely a must-have now. I mean, most of people, especially in countries, in Eastern Europe countries, where we love to have, we love to possess something because we didn't have anything for so many years. That's why it's so important. Yes, I want to have a car. I need to have a car. Actually, we believe that in future, no, you don't need a car. You need a possibility to move. You need a convenient multimodal platform which will help you to change the place you are. And that's why we need the C letter, because only, I mean, all these new apps, Uber, My Taxi, all the car sharings, the bike sharings that are very popular in Poland, all of them are basing on mobile apps. So we cannot really introduce the S without the C. And then the next goal is actually to make the shared mobility as convenient as the exclusive mobility. For that, however, we need another letter, which is A. I mean, the ultimate goal here is that a self-driving car picks you up from wherever you want, takes you to your destination place. In the meantime, you can work, talk with friends, go to sleep, do whatever you want. And then you don't really care what will happen with this car later because it leaves. Then also in the cities, we do not need so many parking spots because you don't park this car. This car drives further and takes another passenger. You don't need to worry about this car because it's not your car. I mean, there is some company, some kind of operator, of course they have to worry about it, but not you, not the user. But for that we need an A, and of course, as I said, this is not only a matter of technology, this is also a matter of legislation, of trust of the people. It will probably come in steps. So for example, in Dubai, the Sheikh Mohammed has announced that he wants to have, I'm not sure, I think 30% of autonomous fleet within next 10 years on the streets. I mean, he really wants 10% of the 30% of the cars on Dubai's streets be autonomous. Probably we will wait a little bit longer for that, but it will come. And I am not talking here only about passenger cars. Please remember that it's about all the mobility. The same thing is about transportation, about trucks, about vans. In fact, trucks and vans probably could earn even more from the autonomous drive because these are machines not made for pleasure, not made for people's transport. They are workers, they are hard workers. The more the car works, the more it earns for its owner. It doesn't need to rest, it doesn't need to sleep, it doesn't need to stop like now the modern trucks need to. That's why it's really important, and although it's also more complicated, please remember that having a very big, heavy truck on the street, even if it's just 25 tons, it's something totally different than a passenger car. The systems must be much more intelligent. They have to be much more predictive. It's, you know, like a huge elephant that when it's going too fast, it must stop, and it takes a long time to stop for it. So this is a big challenge, but yes, it will come, and also, of course, to the buses. Just a couple of examples of shared services companies that are a part of Daimler. The one mostly known here in Poland is My Taxi, which I think is not operating now in Szczecin, but it's coming also to Szczecin. Maybe you don't know that Flixbus, the previously known company as in Poland as Polski Bus, is also a part of our company. We have also many more, like Car2Go, a very popular car sharing system, mostly in Western Europe, basing on smart cars, but not only smart cars. Of course, now we are also turning into electric cars. And there are many more. For example, Movil, which is, you can see the logo here, which is a multimodal transportation platform something a bit like jakdojadę.pl, perhaps you know it. So a site or an app that helps you find different buses and make one trip with them. But this one will not only contain buses, it will contain all available shared mobility services. So it will tell you that, okay, to get there the fastest way you can, take the bus, and then there is a Veturilo bike sharing station, take a bus, take a ride with a bike, because no bus goes to where you are going. Or it's winter, so maybe no, don't take the bike, but there you have a car sharing station, so take a car. Oh, you don't have a driving license, then I propose that you use a taxi. So that would be all in a brief description of what is CASE. As you see, it's not, of course, it's basically about technology, but at the end, it only has sense if we really start using it, if we really can believe in it. And this is really a huge challenge to implement all these different letters, which are coming sooner or later. Many people don't believe in it. Many people say, for example, Poland is not a good market for electric cars because the real car and real men use only V6, V8, and I need a manual gear for that. Well, maybe, however, I believe that times change. Electric cars will come, autonomous cars will come, shared services will come, and connected services are already here. So I will be very happy to answer any of your questions later, but until now, thank you very much and see you.